Greenland, Antarctica are home to most of the world's glacial ice that accumulates on land. That's why scientists focus their energy here first when looking for answers about sea level rise. Combined, these two regions contain enough ice that if it were to melt all at once, sea levels would increase by nearly 215 feet. Now that isn't going to happen anytime soon, but even a few feet of sea level rise would be disastrous for the planet's coastal communities. For most people, these processes are happening so far away that it's hard to imagine how melting at the poles even occurs. So let's get into that. A healthy glacier is one that accumulates the same amount of snowfall as it loses. It's a system at equilibrium. Unfortunately, today's glaciers and ice sheets are not in equilibrium. Here's what it means. In Greenland, when warm summer air melts the surface of a glacier, the meltwater erodes down through the ice. It makes its way down to the bottom of the glacier where it runs between the ice and the bedrock and eventually shoots out in a plume at the base of the glacier. The meltwater plume is lighter because it doesn't contain salt. It's actually fresh water. It rises toward the surface, mixing warm salty ocean water on the upside in the process. The warm water then rubs up against the bottom of the glacier, causing even more of the glacier to melt. This often leads to calving, where ice cracks and breaks off into large icebergs. In addition to melting caused by warm air and a warm ocean, Antarctica faces another challenge. The bedrock itself. Researchers often split Antarctica into two regions, East and West. Unlike East Antarctica, the bedrock that makes up West Antarctica is below sea level. That means it's actually underwater. Warmer water has an easier time sweeping in between the continental shelf and the ice sheet and thereby melting the ice from below. This causes the ice shelves to thin and break off into the ocean. Melting and ice loss have accelerated at both poles in recent years. The more we learn about this complicated process, the more accurately we will be able to predict sea level rise far into the future.